My government is of the firm conviction that the role of the private sector in the development of our national economy is crucial. It is the very essence of our economic policy, philosophy, and has been so for 70 odd years. In the 1950s, at the height of the Cold War, Joseph Boaziadankwa, one of the revered founding fathers of our nation, stated, when defining the vision and policy of our party, that, and I quote, "Our duty is to liberate the energies of the people for the growth of a property-owning democracy in this land, with the right to life and freedom and justice as the principles to which the government and laws of the land should be dedicated to, in order specifically to enrich the lives, property, and liberty of each and every citizen," unquote. We've never wavered in our belief that given an enabling environment, the ingenuity, creativity, and sense of enterprise of the Ghanaian will enable us rapidly to develop a strong, powerful economy, which will deliver a good, dignified standard of living to our people. In furtherance of this, over the past 15 months in office, we've set about putting in place the measures needed to reduce the cost of doing business and improve the business environment. We've begun to act on the fundamentals of our economy, which in recent years has been in considerable disarray. Our actions have resulted in the growing stability of the macroeconomy and the CD, reduction in inflation, and an abolition of nuisance taxes, whose aim is to shift the focus of the economy from taxation to production. All these measures are being undertaken to stimulate enterprise activity and growth. We also recognize that if in the circumstances of the 21st century we continue to maintain the Gettysburg economy, there will be no future prosperity for the Ghanaian people in the short, medium, or long term. A key challenge of our economy, like many other economies in Africa, is its infrastructural deficit. We're embarking on an aggressive public-private partnership program to attract investment in the development of both our road and railway infrastructure. We're hopeful that with solid private sector participation, we can develop a modern railway network with strong production center linkages and with the potential to connect us to our neighbors to the north, i.e. Burkina Faso, to the west, i.e. Cote d'Ivoire, and to the east, i.e. Togo. We believe that this is an area where British technology and expertise would be very welcome. I am thus notifying the business community in the United Kingdom to take advantage of the growing business-friendly climate in the country, to invest in Ghana. Our flagship policies, captured by the slogans of One District, One Factory, One Village, One Dam, and the Program for Planting for Food and Jobs, map out areas of opportunity, which I commend to you as are doing the areas in the development of renewable energy and ICT growth. There are several projects in roads, water transport, industry, manufacturing, agriculture, petroleum and gas, renewable energy, the exploitation of our mineral wealth of bauxite, iron ore and gold, and the ICT sector amongst others, which are being structured to attract private sector financing. We are conscious the key to attracting private sector investment is the creation of a conducive, business-friendly and peaceful environment, as well as the fashioning of a state machinery fit to provide strong regulatory support for private enterprise to thrive. That for us is the heart of the private-public partnership that can fast-track our development. A state machinery that can manage efficiently its fiscal and monetary responsibilities, that can reform its tax administration to ensure that all private sector operators discharge their full tax obligations to enhance domestic resource mobilization, and that can promote the rule of law, is our aim. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm determined that we change the economic conditions of our country for the better, to ensure that young people see it as a place of opportunities instead of the place from which they flee at the peril of their lives. We need to do all within our power to create an entrepreneurial climate to enable our young people to come up with creative ideas that can be developed into businesses. Let me assure business leaders from the United Kingdom who are present this morning that Ghana is a haven of peace, security and stability, a country where the principles of democratic accountability are now firmly entrenched in its body politic, and where the separation of powers is real to promote accountable governance. We're keen on establishing a business-friendly economy to attract foreign direct investments, to exploit our country's great potential on mutually satisfactory terms. Investments are protected in fact and in law. The rule of law in Ghana is not a slogan, but an operating principle of state development. We want to participate in the global marketplace, not on the basis of the exports of raw materials, but on the basis of things we make. We want to bring greater dignity to the lives of millions of people in Ghana. We want to build a Ghana beyond aid. I believe very strongly that Ghana is in the cusp of a new bold beginning, which will repudiate the recent culture of failure. And I'm expectant that this summit will help facilitate partnerships between Ghanaian and British companies and create the common platform that generates ideas and nurtures them into success. It is my hope that exchanges of this sort will enable the strong relations between Ghana and the United Kingdom to grow even stronger.